I feel some guilt. The fact that my salary exceeds 20-fold. School teachers in states like Oklahoma, they get $3,200 a year, which is a disgrace, school teachers' salaries. Education is the answer to everything. World leadership hinges on education. Take Zsa Gabor, will get $50,000 a week in Las Vegas, and school teachers' top salary, $6,000 a year. This is really sick to me. That's the kind of sick material that I wish Time would have written about. I'm not that much of a moralist. If I were, I would be donating my salary then to school teachers. You know, I admit that. If a man came to me and said, well, we're going to levy a tax and we're going to raise school teacher salaries to $750 a week, I would approve of it and pay the tax like that. Because I realize it's an insurance factor. If school teachers get that kind of money, then the education system will change immediately. I'm a hustler. As long as they give, I'll grab. But I know that someday they're going to have a tribunal. We'll all have to answer, I'm sure of that. I'm just waiting for the day. I'm saving some money to give back. I know I was stealing. I didn't mean to take it. They gave it to me. We'll all have to answer. They'll line us up. The guy will be in the black shrouds, all the performers. All right, line them up. All the offenders there. State their names and their salaries. The sentences will be then meted out. The first offender, what is your name there? Frankie Lane. How much do you make a week, Mr. Lane? $10,000 to $12,000 a week. It's remarkable. What do you do to earn from $10,000 to $12,000 a week? Do you spend one? Burn his wig. Break his legs, 30 years in jail. Get them up here, the next one. What is your name?
Sophie Tucker.
And how much do you make a week, Miss Tucker?
$20,000 to $30,000
a week. What do you do to earn $20,000 to $30,000 a week?
I'm the last of the red hot.
Burn her Jewish records and jellies and the crepe gowns with a sweat under the arm. Get rid of her. Get them up here, the next one.
The one that's worshiping the bronze god of Frank Sinatra.
What is your name? Sammy Davis Jr. And how much do you make a week, Mr. Jr.? $20,000, sometimes $30,000 a week. What do you do to earn from $20,000 to $30,000 a week?
Hey, Dean, I got a boot. Tell
that old black. Take away his Jewish star and stocking cap. And the religious statue of Elizabeth Taylor. 30 years in Biloxi. All right. Now. Now, here is another funny and ridiculously incongruous facet to this industry. Somewhere along the way, a really funny stratification started, a semantic cespool. When you hear people say, good rooms, classrooms. And I always say that if I came to this town and they're going to give me $5,000 a week to work the Fairmont, or they're going to give me $5,050 a week to work the Christian Science Reading Room, I'll be at the reading room like that. Without thinking twice. There are good rooms I like to work. The editorial office of the New York Times is a good room. Rooms don't have any identity. But a lot of guys don't feel that way. And this is about such a comic. Scene opens up Sherman Oaks, California. There with his agent. The pool isn't in yet, but the patio is dry. Well, bullets... I'm tired of working the toilets, man. I've had it. I mean, you don't know. It's a drag, man. There's a lot of guys who start me in a business. They've been on Steve Allen show, Sullivan show. I'm not moving, man. Why I'm not moving, I figured out, is I never worked a classroom. I want you to get me a class date, man. I'll work it for short line, but I need one class date. Hey, why don't you stop breaking my chops, huh? You're getting $3,500 a week in Vegas in the lounge. That spit? Yeah, but it's not... It's the lounge again. It's not the big room, man. But you don't need it, sweetie, baby, booby, sweetie. I want a class date. I can't keep going back to Montreal. That's it. I want a class date. All right, like what? I don't know. I was thinking, how about the Palladium Theater in London? What are you, a nut? It's a vaudeville house. It's a vaudeville house. Joey Bishop played it. Alan King played it. Look, I don't want no grief with you, man. Forget it. You don't get me the Palladium. I want a release in the office, and that's it. They argue back and forth 2 weeks later.
All right, you satisfied?
Making an old man out of me, I'm telling you. You're going to open up the 19th with Georgia Gibbs, Bobby Breen, and Helen Noga, Bruno Hauptmann's son, for some insurance there. He's doing a double with Barbara Burns Jr. It's called Smoke the Bazooka. Then I think they're going to bring in, for the weekend, Leibowitz and the Scottsboro Boys for poetry and jazz. And it'll swim. But if you bomb, I'm telling you, it's not the theater for you. You're all right in the joints, man, but this is a different kind of... Why don't you stop? I'm going to murder these people, man. Murder them. You'll end up booking the house, I'm telling you, man. All right. And I got my act tight now. I got 24 minutes of dynamite. I know every laugh is... Yeah, I can work to all kinds of people, too. Work to Jewish people, I learn how to say tokus, all right? Now, when I work to musicians, I do a bit called Hep Smoker Reefer, all right? Got them right in my pocket. Work to the eggheads, I do that Stevenson stuff. I got it down, man. 24 minutes, wherever I go, I kill them. All right, now what happens? He gets the date, the snob appeal sets in, the good room, the classroom. First thing he does, gets those corny mohair suits they got there, the shirt with the ruffles, shoes with the tassels. Gets all his music recopied. Frank Dell, Dean of Satire and Mimicry, Funatics. Now, all the people in town give him the going-away party. The saints and sinners who have meetings and make nothing but scatological references, out-and-out oral pornography, and then rationalize by giving milk to children at the end, right? The friars, the lambs, and all those nitwit groups. Now, he's made it, right? And he got the cufflinks and the gang at Lindy's Knock 'em Dead Sweetie. It starts, a rehearsal, a 10-act bill. They've got Jerry Lewis in for 4 days to close because his new disease and he'll help everybody out. No laughs, a lot of charity, though. He's helping muscular dystrophy that he brought about. Hey, Dean. And, don't give to the other muscular dystrophy, just to his. It's a rehearsal.
All right, boys and girls, line it up, Freddie. Pass out the books there, all right? Let's see. The first act will be the Dunhills, all right? Letter A, back to the coda, begin, and suck four, and bang. Okay, segue into the Nick Lucas tribute. Tiptoe through the tulips. Okay, tacit banjo chorus, and sing. Off into Maria Callas. Canceled? All right. All right. Bronco and his dog. How much is that dog in the window? Next cue, drummer catch it with the rim shot as he says, what do we do when we see Hitler? Dogless leg crashed. There we go. Next there, Ron and his Swiss bells. All right, Ron, work it. The bells of St. Mary, bom, bom, bom. An epileptic, they put him to work. Good boy, the Americans are marvelous for rehabilitating people. That's smashing. Next into Wanda and her birds. Okay, Wanda, no use working the bees, sweetheart. Leave them in the cages. All right, we'll just take it for time, okay. Da da dum ya da 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 dum. Sustain the chord. Key bird comes out, takes the flags out of her mouth into over there. It's a long way to Tipperary. My buddy, cha cha and off. All right. There you go. Okay. All right, get the comedian up here. Frank Dell. Come up here, son. Let's see, who to comic reaches mic? Fade, okay, next cue. That's why Christine can never come home. All right, take it away. That's why Christine never can, letter A. Next cue, Liberace, what crap. Yes. Let's see, that's, remember Pearl Harbor? Oh, really? Next year. Let's go up to show business heaven. And the great Al Jolson. Same crap week after week. Disgusting. Oh, no, son, I'm sorry. We were just talking over some boys that were here before. I'm sure you do the impressions different. You probably do them as children. Music is beautiful. We'll talk about it tonight. That night, the show. One of these opening nights where everybody is just killing the audience, one act after the other. Tremendous amount of rapport between every performer and the audience. Now, Georgia Gibbs is on. This comic follows her. Georgia Gibbs has now been on for 45 minutes, and she's really wrapping them up. Now she's really gaining momentum. Does the Broadway Melody 1938 medley. And she's got them like this, holding them. Ben-Hur, Daddy, Yajon. Off, on, now into heavyweight numbers. Ailey, Ailey. Boom. Back now. The tribute to Sir Harry Lauder. Boom, boom. Okay, Vigino Mare, Sorrento, killing them. Off, standing ovation, finally gets off. The comic is still waiting. He's had a wonderful afternoon. He's given his picture to the delicatessen, and he's swinging, right? Ladies and gentlemen, the Palladium Theatre proudly presents America's fastest rising young comedian and dean of satire, Mr. Frank Dell. Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and certainly nice to be here at the most famous theatre in the world, the wonderful Palladium Theatre. Ha ha! Well, folks, I just got back from Las Wages, Nevada. Funny thing about working Las Wages, folks, the way to make a lot of money there, when you get off the plane, walk right into the propeller. I tell you, funny thing happened, folks. This little pansy walked into the bar, and then into the motel jokes, the army jokes, the impressions, 10, 12, 15 minutes, and he's bombing nothing, but not left one. Now he goes into the dying jokes. Oh, well, folks, I wasn't born here, but I'm sure dying here. Ha! A lot of different ways to die. And blah, blah, blah. Now he starts with putting the audience down. Well, Freddie boy, I see it's little Squaresville. Little Squaresville for the first show. The greatest in them all. Oh, not the baby, baby. Crap. Let's go to show business heaven. How about it, maestro, eh? How about it, maestro? Alec, electrician. Let's hit it, boys. I'll rock by my baby. Walks off, gets a little courtesy applause. Two people, sounds like Citizen Kane. Terrible. The only two people that are laughing are the two usherettes who bawl everybody who play the theater. Find the comic back in his dressing room. Knock at the door. Enter the house booker, the employer. Come here. Oh, hello, son. How do you do? My name is Val Parnell. I'm the house booker here, and you had quite a grim crowd out there, didn't you? I don't think I've seen anything like this in quite a few years. You just couldn't get off the ground. You were out there for a couple of hours, weren't you? Boy, that was certainly rough. Unfortunately, I didn't see you work while I was in New York. Jack Durant told me that you did quite a good job in Rochester. And bit for bit, to take your act apart, let's see now. That Hep Smoke Aretha bit was quite avant-garde. We never had any reefer humor here. And see if Miss Toklas is in with a candy for me. And you're quite a sensitive performer. That was evidenced by the continual references to Liberace and Christina, I guess. My wife thought you were marvelous. She got all that good Hep stuff you did. After you went off, we had a bit of a meeting, and we kicked a lot of ideas around. And one of them was that there's a boat leaving Thursday, and I was wondering if you'd mind signing this release here. Yeah. This is no reflection on your talent. You're very clever, but we'll protect each other. Just sign it right here. Sign what? The release. What do you think? You got a banana here, Johnny? Oh, I don't understand the reference to foodstuff, son. What are you putting me on? You mean to tell me every comedian that comes out here breaks up the first show? Now I'm used to working at smart, sophisticated nightclubs. You know, you got a lot of kids out there, don't know what the hell is going on, don't know what the score is. I didn't dig my fag bits and the reefer bits. I didn't even do my fag at the ball game yet. son, I'm afraid it's not the bits, you see, it's the totality. You see, I know this. You don't know nothing, you nitwit. You come over here, man. Like, just stay there. You're not going to cancel me out of here, man. I don't know who the hell you think you're talking to, but this is it for me, man. This isn't Toledo. This is across the ocean. You can't cancel me like this. Now, wait a minute, man. Just a minute now. Sorry I got hot with you like that, man, but you got to give me another chance, man. You got to pay the cop out of like this, but this means a lot to me, man. Like, in first place, my manager didn't want me to have it. And you realize what the hell Variety will do to me? Let me do tonight, Joe. Please, just tonight, all right? All right, son, we'll see what tonight brings. That night, Georgia Gibbs has been on now for 2 hours. She's now into her tribute to Sophie Tucker, Hello God number. And just killing the people. Really wrapped up now in a nice parcel. And she's wailing. Boom, boom. Off. Bows. Now into offbeat Scotch bits. Will Fife, My Heart Belongs to Glasgow. And on and on. And after murdering the audience, leaves them limp, she comes back and does this for an encore. Oh, you've been so good to me, ladies and gentlemen. Do you know, I realize that a vaudeville stage is no place for sentiment. But I wonder if at this time we could have a moment of silence for the poor boys who went to Dunkirk and never came back. Boys who will never again see the bright lights of Piccadilly. Boys who are gone. Why are the boys gone? The boys are dead. You know, you couldn't follow that except a leper on the Art Baker show. You asked for it, an arm, right? Finally, she walks off, people sobbing. The audience is completely depressed. The ones that aren't sobbing uncontrollably are grabbing for digitalis. Just too much. Ladies and gentlemen, the Palladium Theater proudly presents America's fastest rising young comedian and dean of satire. Here he is, it's fun time, Frank Dell. Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and nice to be here at the most famous theater in the world, the wonderful Palladium Theater. Folks, a funny thing, I just got back from a delightful, crazy little town, a crazy, crazy place called Las Wages. You know, folks, a funny thing about working Las Wages, Nevada, and ring-a-ding, into the toilet for good this time, forget it. Not one lead. Oh, I see, we got little Squaresville again, little Squaresville, Squaresville. Now, the manager is watching him from the wings. All right, oh, that's right, you just keep watching me, his concept of being hip. Don't you worry, a nitwit, I'll grab him. A little slow starter. A little backstage rib, folks. We always rib each other, me and the manager. Ha ha, thought you'd get a kick out of it. All right. Keeps reaching, punching her. Nice, tasty Martha Rabbits picking his nose heavy in. Do a little bit here and gonna go up and ring-a-ding. And it's granite out there. Jefferson, Washington, Lincoln. Forget it. It's like not there, but keep punching and punching it. Nice way to treat an American, folks. Thanks a lot for that. Yeah, and I was in on a few bucks that went to you people, too. I was in the service, too, guys. That means anything to you, maybe. I was over there myself. He's sweating. He's nervous. He's doing Georgia Gibbs' tunes. At a left field, right? And let's go to heaven with show business. Oh, yeah, the other day I heard a fella, Faye, forget it. Get it. Nothing. They're looking at a mean face. It's just staring up there. 1,500 people in oil painting. It's right. All right, folks. Then a little bit here. Screw Ireland, folks. How about that, huh? They really bum rapped you, the IRA. I read about them. They're really no good. Screw the Irish. What do you say about that one, gang? Yeah, sir. They really give you a hard time, those Micks. How about it, folks? Screw the Irish. What do you say about that thing, huh? Okay. A heckler in the balcony. That's the funniest thing you've said all night, boy. That's right. Screw Ireland. Screw Ireland. Take it easy, Buster. Let's not get out of line. It's just a little joke now. Buster, screw Ireland. Screw Ireland. The man manager. What's going on out there? Screw Ireland! Screw Ireland! Get that bum off the stage! Go to the newsreel! Screw the bastard Irish! Get the bobbies! Back, folks! Screw the Irish! They stole the grail! Back! Back to the dressing room! Knock at the door. Enter once again. The house booker. Ooh, goddamn, son. Oh, dear. Oh, I don't believe what's going on out there. Go ahead, you sadist. Get a nail. Do it upright. I don't believe what went on out there. Just don't believe it. You're a bloody Mau Mau. I swear to God, son, Robert Rourke really missed something with you. Now, look, son, I don't mind these boys that come out and they start with the same word every night. They finish with the same word. Perhaps they're not too creative or funny, maybe. But goddamn, son, you've got a knack of making people vicious. There's a difference in not getting laughs and changing the architecture of the theater. You're not funny, that's all. I mean, face it. How old a man are you? I should say 34 or 35. It's not too late. You know, take the cloth, something. Forget it. You might be good with those evangelist things, saving people. What the hell are you staring at me for, you idiot? You don't use narcotics, do you? Here, son, sign it here right where it says witnesses while you've still got the fingers to do it with. Don't give me wait a minute, I lied about my wife. Here, right here, sign it now, wait a minute. Wait a minute for what? The return of the Crusades? There's only one thing fixed dead center in my mind, that there's a boat leaving Thursday. And I guess you'll be goddamn well glad to get on it, son. We'll get you out of the country some way. I believe Julian Eltinge left a wig in the closet many years ago. Now, if I can only straighten out Governor Long. He doesn't want to listen to me. I would have had him over, but he won't dress, you know. Just sits in his pajamas, won't put his teeth in or anything. He's sitting cursing at his wife, running around, making speeches in motels. He's really a delight, though. He really cracked me up. He had the greatest political campaign of any public figure. I saw him on television. Dig his political platform. I'm not a nut. What is that, right? No honesty, better schools. I'm not a nut, that's all I got. So I don't wet the bed, elect me, that's all. Okay. Governor Long is really a sign of our times. How did the governor get out? He fired the people who put him in. Go fight that kind of action. You're a nut, you're fired. If you read time, they grabbed him making phone calls. Ding-ding-ding. Hello, this is Governor Long. Give me McElroy, Secretary of Defense. Hello, Mac. This is the governor. Yes, they give me a lot of trouble down here, son. Jean Lafitte is bombarding us again. Are you there? It's the governor. He whacked out. He's ding-a-ling, Daddy. Forget the re-election. Governor! All right, Your Majesty. Don't talk to any newspapers whatsoever. The Watchtower? All right. Yes. Yes. All right, we're going to send some FBI men down to take care of you. Yes. They'll be dressing all in white. It's warm in Washington now. Mm-hmm, good deal. All right, Governor. Well, let's see now. The FBI men will be here soon. A lot of important things to do today. Let's see what I have to do. Empty the garbage and, Yeah, I gotta meet Aaron Burr for lunch and, coming along.
Yes, what is it?
The FBI men are here to see you.
Thank you. You're free, Bueller.
The last act of us.
If you've seen me work before, you know I stole that voice from another characterization. That's actually Governor Farbus's voice when he was popular. It's weird, you fickle, you people. You swing with one hero and... taken out of the home of Governor Farbus. The daughter.
Daddy, I got a wonderful surprise for you.
Well, what is it, Belle of the South?
Well, Daddy, your daughter Sheila Jaw is going to get married.
Married? Well, that certainly brings a warm spot to my old southern heart. Can't believe you're such a big girl, Sheila, getting married. You marrying a local boy?
No, Daddy, he's a New York stage actor. Mom and I met him last year in Freeport, Long Island.
Well, I've never had too much truck with stage people, but I'm sure if my daughter Sheila Joy picked him out, he's a fine, upstanding man. What's his name, sugar?
Harry Belafonte.
Italian boy, eh? Well...